Good afternoon, everybody. This is Sean Copeland. Today is Saturday, December the 30th. Believe it or not, there is just one day left in 2023. And welcome to our last 2023 life-changing edition of the Kingdom Driven CEO. So everybody that knows me knows how much I love the new year. And I understand that January the 1st, which is Monday, is another day. It's just another day on the calendar. There is no magic to it being the first day of 2024. However, in our lives, I think it is important that we have certain cadence, that we have kind of a rhythm that we live our lives in, that there are times when we step back and kind of reevaluate our life, how we can improve, how we could grow closer to God, adjustments that we want to make going forward. And so I've been praying through what to share with you today, and I'm excited to share with you six things that I think we need to leave behind as we go into 2024, and three tips to make 2024 your best year yet. So let me just jump straight in, and I want to tell you that the genesis of this idea came from a Facebook post that I saw from Craig Rochelle, the pastor of Life Church here in Oklahoma. That's not where we go to church, and I'm not trying to plagiarize his information, but I thought it was such a great idea that I began to pray through some thoughts of my own as well, and I hope you enjoy these. These are six things to let go of as we go into 2024. Let's leave them behind in 2023. Number one is fear of the future. Matthew 6:34 says, "Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own." Do you catch yourself thinking about the future, worrying about the future? I do. We've got some huge initiatives at the bank coming up this year. We've got some big things coming up as a family in 2024. So I find myself tending to look forward and worrying about the future. But that is not what God has called us to do. He calls us to live one day at a time, trust in Him, focus on Him, and let's let fear of the future stay in 2023. This is particularly important given the status of our world. I understand that the Israeli conflict, Palestinian conflict is going on. I understand Ukraine-Russia is still going on. I understand China could invade Taiwan. I understand that there are all kinds of things that could happen in 2024. But what I also understand is it does us no good to sit around and worry about those. And let's just focus on one day at a time. The second thing that we want to leave behind in 2023 is the desire to be in control. Jeremiah 29:11, my life verse says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." We think that we have a lot of control. And one thing that the Lord has shown me in my life is that I don't. I can simply each day pray, start the day off with Him, listen as closely as I can to His direction for me, follow His guiding, follow His commandments, live as close to Him as I can throughout the day, make the best decisions I can make, prioritize the best that I can, and then I have to leave the results to Him. When I do that, and when I realize that I am not in control, I am much happier, I am less stressed, and I find that I am always living more closely to Jesus when I submit my life to Him. So let's leave the desire to be in control and to control our circumstances behind in 2023, and instead, let's completely trust in the Lord who loves you more than you can ever imagine. The number three thing that we want to leave behind in 2023 is the pain of regret. There are things that all of us have done, including me, that we wish we could take back, we wish we hadn't have done, we feel regretful. Maybe they happened last year, maybe they happened earlier in our lives. But 1 John 1:19 says this, "If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness." So what John is saying here is let it go. It doesn't do any good to look back on, you know, sins that we have committed, mistakes that we have made, things that we have said that we wish we hadn't have said, you know, things that investments we've made we wish we hadn't have made. That's certainly one of mine. You know, there are a lot of things that we can look back on with regret, but the problem is all that is a boat anchor to keep us from achieving God's will in our lives. The pain of regret kept me on the sideline from leading spiritually for about two-thirds of my life. It took me a really long time to get past the mistakes that I made, the sins that I had made, and realize that nobody but Jesus is perfect. And if we all sat around waiting to be perfect, there wouldn't be anybody leading anyone spiritually at all. So in 2023, we want to leave the pain of regret behind. Very similarly, in 2023, we want to leave the shame from our past behind. So regret may have to do with just things where we've made mistakes. You know, maybe we just made bad decisions and those have had bad outcomes. Shame is largely much deeper than that. It may be something that we have done that we are ashamed of. It may be something that someone has done to us that we are ashamed of. It may be our background. It may be our family. There are a lot of things that we can feel shame for, but God is calling us to let that go. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come, the old has gone, the new is here." It is time to turn the page. I got a news bulletin for you. We have all done things we're ashamed of. If anybody tells you they haven't, they should be ashamed because they are not telling the truth. We all have fallen short of God's glory. We know that. However, he does not want us to live there. He wants us to move past it, push past it, and become the new creation that he desires us to be. And no better time to do that than as we are moving into a new year in 2024. The next thing we want to leave behind in 2023 is unforgiveness. There is an enormous amount of baggage that goes with not forgiving others. And I know for a fact that if you can hear my voice out there somewhere, if you're one of our 35,000 listeners, somebody has done you wrong. That is a fact. We have all had people who have done us wrong. Maybe it was in a business deal. Maybe it was parents that left you when you were young and you've never met. You know, it could be anything. Maybe it was stealing. You feel like somebody stole something that was dear to you or someone that was dear to you. But let me tell you what the Bible says. Ephesians 4:32 says, "Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ God forgave you." God is saying, if you want the forgiveness of others, and particularly the forgiveness that comes along with Jesus Christ dying on the cross for us, if we want that forgiveness, we have to be willing to give forgiveness. When I've done some mission work down in Brazil, and one of the things that I have learned is that much of the sickness that plagues that population came from unforgiveness. They hold on to grudges. They are so angry. They have a very, very difficult time letting go. And we have the same problem here in America. The problem is we try to medicate it. So we try to look to all kinds of drugs and self-help books and this and that, when the answer is Jesus Christ. He forgives you. He forgives me fully. He says we are now as pure and as white as snow, and we need to pass that same forgiveness on to others. The only person you are hurting with unforgiveness is yourself. Then finally, the last thing that we need to leave behind in 2023 is comparison. You know, there's a saying that comparison will make you feel either superior or inferior, and neither of these honors God. So let's think about it. If you are proud, if you look at blessings that the Lord has given you, and maybe it's financial gain, maybe it's position, whatever it is, if you look at others and you compare that you are better than them, that makes you feel superior, and that is not honoring to God. God does not want that. However, He also does not want us looking at others and feeling inferior, as if, you know, we are less than they are, that they are better than us in some way. That also does not honor God. In Galatians 6, it says, don't compare yourself with others. Just look at your own work to see if you have done anything to be proud of. Philippians 2 says, rather in humility, value others above yourselves, not looking to your own interest, but each of you to the interests of others. So God is calling us today to run our race. He wants us to run the race that He has in store for me and you, not try to run somebody else's race, not try to compare to somebody else. One of the biggest breakthroughs that I had in business was I stopped looking at my competitors. Now, I would analyze them. I would look for ideas that they did. You know, I mean, if they were doing things better than me, I wanted to learn from it. But I stopped comparing myself to them, and we just started running our own race. My theory was, if we were living our core purpose of showing God's love to our employees, clients, and communities, and if we were excellent for our customers, if we were excellent for our employees, that's really all we could do. It didn't make sense to get all caught up in looking at others and comparing. So as we leave 2023, let's leave comparison behind. Let's be grateful for what we have been given, and let's focus on running the race that God has laid out before us. So let me give you just a quick summary, real quick, of the six things we want to let go of in 2024. Number one, we want to let go of fear of the future. Number two, let go of the desire to control. Number three, let go of the pain of regret. Number four, let go of the shame from our past. Number five, let go of unforgiveness. And number six, let go of comparison. So as we close, I want to give you three ideas that have worked for me over the years that I think could help get your new year started off the right way. Number one, I want you to consider writing daily positive affirmations to yourself that you read every single day. I have mine at work, and before I start the work day, I always stop and read these affirmations. And let me read to you my five, and then I would encourage you to write 5 to 7 about yourself as well. Mine are, I am confident in my abilities and trust in myself to make the best decisions for my life, my coworkers, and my family. I am worthy of love and respect, both from others and from myself. I am capable of achieving my goals and creating the life that God wants me to have. I am strong, both physically and mentally, and I can overcome any obstacle. And I am grateful for all the blessings in my life and appreciate the people and the God who supports me. So those are just some ideas. And what I would do is I would think about areas where perhaps you struggle more. So, you know, maybe it's finances. Maybe you feel scarcity in finances. You'll want to write an affirmation about having plenty, having enough, having sufficient resources. You know, maybe it's fear that you struggle with. Then write an affirmation about the fact that you can fully trust in God to take care of you today and you live with no fear. Those types of things. So focus in on what is most important to you, where you feel like you need the most affirmation. And I want to encourage you to write at least 5 to 7 positive affirmations that you read every single day in 2024. The second idea that I want to share with you is one that has been very powerful for me, and that is to write a letter to yourself and date it December 31st, 2024. And in that letter, you are going to summarize all of the amazing things that happened to you this year. Okay, so you're going to go through whatever your goals are. If you want to get healthier, if you want to go on a vacation, if you want a promotion, if you want closer friendships, you know, if you're looking for a significant other, whatever it is that is important to you, if you want to draw closer to Jesus Christ, whatever that may be, write it to yourself as if it has already happened. Okay. And then read it, and then put it away, and then you're going to bring it back out on 12/31/24. Now, I will be honest, I also read mine once a month. So on the first day of every month, I have on my calendar that I'll pull out the letter, and I will read it, and I think it helps us to script in a positive way and achieve the goals that we laid out in that letter. And then finally, I want to encourage us as we close today to change our definition of success. I believe so much of our problem today is that we do not think about ourselves and our lives in the right way. For years, I wanted to achieve certain financial goals. I wanted to achieve certain career goals. I wanted to be well-known. You know, I wanted to be well-respected. All of these things were so important to me. And now I am 50 years old. I have been very blessed to achieve many of those goals. And I have found out how hollow they are. This is true. What is important is abiding with Jesus Christ. And I want to encourage us as we move into 2024 to scrap the goals of X number of sales, X number of profit, X number of promotions, all of those types of things. I want us to stop thinking that way. I would like to offer to you that instead, each of our days should be measured by how closely we abide with Jesus. How closely did we listen to the Holy Spirit? How often did we show kindness and compassion to others? How often did we build others up? You know, I believe that when we die and go to heaven, I believe that God, because He is ubiquitous, He is everywhere all the time, I believe that He has an accounting of our life versus our potential. And I think it is moment by moment. Today, if I didn't do this podcast, that is 35,000 people that I would not have been able to impact today. That would have been a miss. And I believe that would have gone into His tally, if you will. Now, that is not going to keep you out of heaven. If you have accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior, you will spend eternity with me and with Him in heaven. However, there are, according to the Bible, eternal rewards for how well we follow His direction here on this earth. So I want to encourage us to stop thinking in terms of worldly pursuits and start thinking about what is eternal, because it is the only thing that is going to matter at the end of our life. So thank you so much for joining this very important final 2023 edition of the Kingdom Driven CEO. I am going to pray us out, and I can't wait to be back with you next year as we launch 2024 together. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for every listener to this podcast. I pray your blessing upon their family. I pray your blessing upon their business. I pray your blessing mostly upon their spiritual walk with you. Draw them close to you, Father. Help 2024 to be a year of breakthrough for them. Father, you are a God of new beginnings. What is in the past is in the past. It no longer matters. We move forward into this new year with you. Help us to be a light unto everybody we come in contact with. We love you so much. In Jesus' name, amen. And I want to thank you so much for being a listener here on the Kingdom Driven CEO. It's a blue.